Dear customer, we thank you for purchasing the dual mode NE4000X syringe pump from Unigenetics. In the earlier video, we have shown that how this pump works separately. But in this video, we are trying to explain if you use two numbers of NE4002X, it can work in a continuous mode. In the continuous mode, if as you can see the setup, the only things we require is two number of pumps and one cable which connects from one pump to the other pump and one PD kit. This is the PD kit. So what happens that in the dual mode, one pump infuses and second pump withdraws, and when the first pump withdraws, the second pump infuses. So from the output, we always get the flow. Because this is a microfluidic pump, so here the maximum flow is very, very less, say 0.5 microliter per minute. So this is the flow that is coming out in the dual mode. Now we will show you how to set up the pump for the dual mode. So we just saw that how the pump works. Now we are going to explain how to set the machine so that we can work in dual mode. So this is the PD kit that comes. The idea is what happens that you can see that this is a wall made up of glass. So what we have to do it, there are two things in the similar way. So one, we will tighten it on a small thread on the first syringe, and in the same way we will tighten the second valve in on the second syringe. So what it does is that once this syringe pushes, the solvent goes from this end and it goes to the reservoir, to the output actually. Once this syringe is pushing, this syringe takes the sample from the reservoir and it comes from this T, and from here it comes into the syringe. When this syringe is withdrawing, this syringe is pushes and the solvent goes out from this one and to the output. So the same thing happens once it is loaded on the syringe pump. Now we are going to explain, though we have already explained how to load the syringe in the previous video of NE4002X, again we are explaining it once again. So in the beginning, if this barrel flange and plunger flange, we have to fix it in this slot and in this slot. If suppose this distance is not good enough, we can make this pusher block free. For that, we have to lift this lever up and rotate it. So now you can see that this pusher block has become free. So what we will do, one flange we will put in this gap and second flange we will put in this gap. And now we will rotate it anti-clockwise from this side. Remember, it is anti-clockwise. It should not be very tight, but it should be tight enough so that this flange doesn't come out. And now this we will rotate clockwise so that both the flanges are fixed. In the same way, we will fix the other syringe also. So we have fixed both the syringes. So once we have fixed the syringes, again we will rotate the lever and make it in the lock position. So it goes down and locks. Now you cannot move the pusher block. So if we want, we can lock the syringe with this one and lock the syringe like this. So the PD kit is fixed. So we have fixed the PD kit physically. Now, to run the pump in dual mode, there is one cable, we call it dual cable 3 or synchronization cable. So if you will see, on the one pump connected to the computer port, and on the other pump also connected to the computer port only. So it will get connected from computer to computer. So as you can see that there are two pumps. Any pump you can use as a master, and any pump you can use as a secondary pump or slave pump. But for the convenience, we have put the sticker so that every time this pump will work as a secondary or slave pump, and this pump will work as a primary or master pump. So the next step is we will give the power. So we will, firstly I will give the power to the slave pump. This is flashing. Press any arrow key, the flash will go. Now I am giving the power to the master pump. This is flashing. Press any key and this goes. To run this pump in dual mode, the operation is slightly different. It's like put the master pump off and press and hold the volume key or function key. Hold it and now put the power on. It comes to continuity, press the left arrow and it comes to reciprocal mode. So you have to put the master pump in the reciprocal mode to run the two pumps in dual mode. Now the next step is, in the secondary pump, we have to give the diameter. So we have already seen in the other video of single any 4002X how to give the diameter. So this syringe is BD 50 ml syringe, so the diameter is 26.59 mm. And then we have to give the volume. Make sure that the volume on the secondary pump should be zero. Zero means it is off. And also make sure that the secondary pump in the beginning is in the withdraw mode. So once you will put this in the withdraw mode, and once the dual mode will start, the master will start in the infusion mode and this will start in the withdraw mode. Now we are coming back to the setting of the master pump. So we have already put it in the reciprocal mode. If you want, I can do it once again. I am putting it off. Hold and press the volume or function key and put the power on. It will show CONT. Press the left hand arrow and it comes to RECP. So RECP is the reciprocal mode. So by doing this, we have configured this pump as a master pump and this pump as a secondary pump. Now what we will do is, we will give the parameters. So firstly we will go to the diameter. So diameter is again 26.59 mm because this is a 50 ml BD syringe. Now we will give the volume. Volume is something like, if you will give a volume of say 900 microliter, then what the syringe will do, it will dispense 900 microliter and this will, the secondary pump will withdraw 900 microliter, and after that the positions will change. This will withdraw 900 microliter and this will infuse 900 microliter. So from the output we will always get the flow. So let me put the volume of 900 microliter only. I will go to volume and then I will put this decimal to the third position. For that I will keep it pressed. 5, 7, 8, 9. Arrow has come to the third. Now I have put the volume as 900 microliter and now I have to put the rate. So rate I will put say 400 microliter per minute. So this is 400 microliter per hour. I have to change it. So again press rate. Now it is flashing. Press right arrow key. Nanoliter per hour. Minute. Nanoliter per minute, microliter per hour, nanoliter per hour, microliter per minute. So my rate is 400 microliter per minute, volume is 900 microliter and diameter same. So this one I will not put in withdraw, I will put in pumping. And this secondary one I have put in withdraw. So I just have to start and let's see what happens. I will put to volume dispensed. So this is showing that how much volume it has dispensed. This will also show some volume dispense, but this is not the right value. If you want to get the right value, use the value of the master pump only. So you can see that you will get a continuous flow on the output tubing. So basically I would say that if you will use two pumps, it will always give you a continuous flow and you can run this machine 24 hours, 7 days, not an issue at all. Let me try to explain once more what it is doing now. So you can see that this is in withdraw and this is in pumping. It means that now our flow is coming from this pump or secondary pump. After dispensing 900 microliter, this pump will switch over to the withdraw and this pump will switch over to the pumping. But at the output you will always get the flow. Let's wait for So now after dispensing 900 microliters, you see that this has come to the pumping and this is coming to the withdraw. So this pump is pumping and the flow is coming from this to the output. And this pump is withdrawing and this is taking the solvent in. So I do hope that this video will help you to run the pump. Also, one important thing is that as this is a microfluidic pump, so if you will put this tubing at some height, maybe you will not get the flow, because as you can see that the pump is working at a very, very less flow. So always keep your reservoir or output below the height of the tubing pumps. I do hope that this video must have helped you. If you are having any queries, please do let us know. Thank you very much.